What's up, guys? It's Kotetsu here, and today we are excited to go back to be playing Zelda Breath of the Wild. But anyway, we're going to continue on our playthrough with Zelda Breath of the Wild. The last episode, we finally woke Link up from a 100-year slumber, which is pretty... I asked myself this question, like, is Breath of the Wild just a, is it a, another retelling of the story of Link and Zelda, or are they, like, starting it off from one of the past games and then saying, oh, Link was asleep for 100 years, but he just doesn't remember what the heck happened. But, anyway, we're going to go ahead and continue on from our last save point. We also, what else happened? We met the old man. I know who he is, but I'm not going to tell you guys who he is. And he's saying that we have to collect all 3 shrines, visit all 3 shrines, and, collect the treasure from those shrines so we can get that paraglide. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to do another shrine today and do a little exploring as well. So, yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Sorry. Always dehydrated. Always dehydrated. I get dehydrated really quickly, especially when I'm doing these. So what we're going to do is he was telling us to fast travel over to the tower we were at before. So we're going to go ahead and go travel here. Get a nice little, like, teleportation animation. It would kind of remind you of Twilight Princess, but, like, the lighter side of your teleportation. It's, like, the dark version of when, like, Dark Link or Wolf Link will teleport from a place to another. Yes, I know that. Let you guys know. I played Twilight Princess. I didn't finish it too much. I got to the end, but I just didn't finish it. But, yeah, I wish I could have, but I love that game so much. Twilight Princess was really cool. I think Twilight Princess is one of my favorite Zelda games alongside Wind Waker. I never played Skyward Sword. I kind of wanted to, but I never did. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised it took you so long to catch up with an old man like me. Whatever, dude. How did you... Oh, leave an old man his secrets. Now then. I want you to join me up here. I want you to join me up here so you can use this as a vantage point to search for shrines. Did you know about the scope on your Sheikah Slate? Look through it, and you can stick a pin anywhere you'd like to mark on your map. So we're going to hit the press down on the right stick here, and then we place a pin using the A button. We're going to do that now. The pins on your map serve as a reference point for your travels. Just stick a pin anywhere you're interested in. All right, got it. Go ahead and take a look at if you feel inclined to do so. I get so dehydrated now. It's crazy. I don't know why. I get super dehydrated now. Maybe I'm still sick in a way, but whatever. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and use this, the Sheikah Slate, and you can use the function on the Joy-Con, so I know where a couple of them are. So there's one over up here, up there. There's another one somewhere around here as well. It's close by, right there. And there's one pretty close. It's over here, actually. We're going to go over there right now. And then, where is it? I just saw it. There it is. Right there. Alright, so we marked all of them. At least, I think that's all of them close by. Yeah, that's all of them. when I first started playing, I marked the map. I went, like, way over here. And I didn't realize until I pulled up the Sheikah Slate. And I was like, wait, no, we're not... We can't go over there yet. So I unpinned it. But these are the three we're gonna go to. The easiest one is right here. We don't have to worry about too much over here. Except for Guardians. There's Guardians over here. But we're gonna go over there right now because it's the easiest and it's the closest one there. But first, I kind of want to show you guys something. Actually, not much of show you guys something, but more of, hey, there's stuff over here. Let's actually go there now and claim it. But this is that's the Shrine of Resurrection. Where happened to? Okay, there we go. I was like, where is the Shrine of Magnesia? So we're gonna go here. And we're going to use our newfound tricks to find some pretty cool chests. Oh my gosh, I get super dehydrated like super quick. I'll drink a gallon of water and in 2 minutes my mouth would be dry. Horrible. All right, so we're going to go around here. And the first chest you see is right there. So we're going to go ahead and use our Tower of Magnesium to pull it forward. And bam! Kick this sucker open. If you're behind it, you kick it. But if you're in front of it, you'll lift it up. So you get amber fossilized resin with a caramel-esque, caramelized, or I think it's caramel-esque. I think it's caramel-esque. A sheen to it. It's been valued as a component in decorations and crafting since ancient time. Now, I'm hoping you can craft weapons in here. That would be super cool. I don't know yet if you can. I'm hoping you can. That would be awesome if you could. So we're going to grab this chest here, and then we get opal here. I think that's what it's called. It's like a water like based material. A valuable ore that gives off a mesmerizing iridescence similar to inside of a seashell. It contains the power of water. So we get that. And then we're going to use this again to get two more. What am I doing? To get two more items here. Luckily, I did this at night once, and I was like, "What if you can use it as a weapon?" And then we had skull bulk ones pop up, and I was just like, "Oh man, this is perfect, perfect timing!" And I was able to use this as a weapon to like whack all these. It's a one shot, which is crazy. It's one shot, which is perfect. So, all right, so we're gonna put this down. We're trying to measure this. I can actually do this actually. And then we're going to set it down here. And we're going to slowly walk up here. I'm just going to shut up because I'm just going to jinx myself. Okay, cool. I was going to jinx myself just now, but let's not do that. So here we get fire arrows. A bundle of five fire arrows. Fire arrows break apart on impact, igniting objects in the immediate area. Incredibly effective against cold things. And that's how it shows us how to change the arrows there, and then we get ice arrows here. A bundle of ice arrows breaks apart upon impact, freezes immediate area, and then also affects me with fire. So let's go ahead and run down here. And that's pretty much it. Those are pretty easy little items to get there. So we're gonna go ahead and head back over to the we're not gonna go to the Guardian Shrine. I'm just gonna walk over here. Because we may find something I haven't, we may find something that I have not even discovered yet, while playing on this playthrough. It was the last playthrough I went through, and I found a couple of things. Oh wait, are those Bokoblin blend? Yes, they are. Okay, we're gonna try to take those guys out. Yeah, we're gonna try to take those guys out. Let's use our bow and arrows. But we're not gonna use any of our special arrows yet. We're gonna save those. Oh, I just got their attention. Let's see if I can hit them like this. Oh, come on. There we go. Crit. Let's go. Want to hit them again? No, but they're flipping out. About, oh, he's not. There we go. Crit. Let's get another one. Oh, come on, he's moving, he's moving, he's moving. There we go. And there we go. Got him. I actually did pretty good, man, when I I had a lot of practice. But when I was playing earlier, I was horrible at my skills as a bowman. I doubted them so much. But we're gonna go ahead and claim our arrows back right now. That's what's so cool. If you like shoot arrows, you can I won't say every time, but most of the time you can claim your arrows back. So just remember where we shot those arrows and then go back and go claim them. Because they're pretty handy. Pretty handy. You don't want to be, you don't, especially in Zelda games, you have to have a good amount of arrows to be able to do some of the stuff you can do. So this is a part that I love to, we're going to do this before. I used to do this part pretty early on. I did it pretty early on when I first got my traveler's bow and I took out those guys there. I used to come here and I would just take them out. But today we're not going to do that. Since we got fire arrows, we're going to take this guy out here. We're going to try to crit this dude here. Boom. There we go. And then we're going to try out our awesome new arrows here. Fire arrows. We're just going to do this. Take these guys out. Oh my gosh, he's still up. What the heck? He's still alive. That's not cool. Let's go ahead and hit him with a fire arrow. He's still up again. What the heck? Oh, we're going to crit this dude. Can we crit him? No. There we go. But he's not down. What the heck? All right, let's go. I want to do the flurry. I've done it before. I want to see if I can do it here. Oh, crap. Okay, that's not good. Because he has a spike vocal club, which is like really good. I think it's like plus 12 compared to my traveler's sword. So let's see if I can dodge it. No, actually, let's heal all the way first, and then let's see if I can get that flurry. There we go. I didn't get to do it all. That sucks. All right, whatever. It's okay. Because he was in the air, I wasn't able to get all of it. That sucks. All right, so we're gonna get this spike boco club. Like I said, plus 12. So we're gonna go ahead and take that. I don't have enough. We're gonna get rid of our standard boco club. Get rid of that. I'm really hoping you get more slots in here, like better clothes and like better slots. That'd be awesome. Sick and tired of having a couple of inventory spots, man. Especially for weapons. Because you get a really cool lance later, and you get a really cool hammer later, so. Okay, so we got fire arrows here. So I think we have about, like, what? We used two. So we have. Oh, there was a keys in here? I don't remember that last time. Okay, so we get some key swings here. They weren't there before. That's funny. Alright, whatever. They're there now. Alright, so let's go ahead and head to this first shrine here. Like I said, we're going to do a bit of adventuring, and then we're going to try to head to our objective as well. Oh, wait, there was something over here too, right? No, why did I think there's a... I thought there was another hidden little passage somewhere. Maybe that's just me. Maybe it's me. Whoa, what is that? There's the chest over here. What? I don't remember that. Oh, because underwater. But still, I don't remember that. So yeah, playing through. What's this? Okay, we found more amber. I mean, it's more amber, but I'm not like tripping out over it. Not now, at least, because we can easily probably find. We can easily use that amber for something. Oh, there we go. The skull boca, the boca blend, the skeleton ones. I'm trying to see if I can. There we go. Try to get that flurry attack going. Oh, they don't even work that well with these guys. Watch out. Look at that skill. classic Zelda. It's gonna break. Oh, what happened? Did my sword? No, my sword didn't break. Why are these guys done? There we go. I guess if there's a head running around still, they're gonna be up. So here you see is a Bokoblin arm. I'm not gonna take it. Well, actually, I did take it. Why did I take it? Made no sense. Bokoblin spear. We don't need it because we get a better spear later. I don't really use Bokoblin spears in here anyway. Go ahead and take this guy out with his buddy's arm. We're not gonna take that. We're gonna take a Bokoblin fang. I don't know why I have this. I really don't. Let's go back to my traveler's sword, please. Or did it break? You know what? It may have broke. I didn't know about it. Alright, so this is... They're guardians here. Wait, what was I going to grab here? There we go. Ancient screw. So we have... We know what an ancient screw is. We got one. I could have swore when I done that in the last place. We got a... it was a spring. I swore it was a... I could have promised it was a swing. Or a spring. So, we have this guardian here. I am not going to fight this guardian right now. No, doesn't make any sense. I don't have, I'm not even equipped to fight a freaking guardian, so we're going to run over here. Search. Okay, ancient gear. A gear used in ancient machinery. Despite being incredibly old, it's still, its built quality is leaping and bounds above anything built using current technology. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and... Oh, crap. No! Alright, so we're gonna try to go straight across, have Link run up the wall, and then... Hop over. Oh, what the heck? He was sitting here waiting for us? No! No! Oh, come on, Link. There we go. That was cool, actually. Grab his traveler. Why can't we grab a traveler's sword? Let's get rid of this arm. We don't need it. We do need the... What the heck? No way. He's not done? He should have been done. Where's his head? You know what? Forget it. We're gonna ignore him. Because he should be dead. He should be dead. I don't understand how he's still walking around. And there's another one there, but we're going to go ahead and ignore those. And we're going to go ahead and continue on with this shrine. Always stay hydrated. Always stay hydrated. I don't know why. I feel like I'm still sick because I get super dehydrated super quickly. Alright, so, to you who sit in the shrine, I am Jabaj, in the name of the Hylia, goddess Hylia, I offer you this challenge, bomb trial. So this is where we get our awesome bombs. We get our little standard round bombs, and then we get our square bombs, which we can set anywhere, so. Which is pretty cool, because they're actually unlimited bombs, which is nice. Unlimited bombs are really nice. Because bombs can be very hard to come by. Along with arrows. Arrows are hard to come by too. And, oh, okay, so my amiibo function is on. Okay. So what I'm going to do with amiibos too, because I have three amiibos here. I have the Wolf Link, I have the Rider Link, and I have the Smash Bros. Link. And I use the Smash Bros. Link in here. And it works. Like 100%. What did I get? I think I got fire bomb arrows from those, actually, which is pretty cool. I always do that. I never press the right button for the bombs or anything like that. And also, if you're in the shrine, if you go right, let's actually do this real quick. We're gonna make some room. We're gonna get rid of this branch. So if you come to the right, put a bomb here. Just drop it. Or actually, let's do this. Let's throw it and then ignite it from here. Again! I always do that. We're gonna do that, and then, and you see, you're gonna get a Traveler's Claymore, which is pretty good. It's plus 10. I do advise getting one of those. They're just as good as axes. Just as good as axes. And then this is where we're gonna switch over and use our these bombs instead. Someone did this too, and it was so funny. I've seen it. So, oh wow, I didn't want to do that. So we're gonna do. Well, that works too. That works too. I pressed the wrong button and it still worked. All right, not mad at that. Not mad at that. I pressed the wrong button and it still worked. That's hilarious. I didn't want to do that either. I don't do that either. Oh man, that's funny. All right. We're gonna go over here. Me and buttons are not pressing all the wrong buttons. There we go. I'm pressing all the wrong buttons. So we're gonna go on here, and then there's a chest here. What's here? I forgot. I think it's an amber or an opal. Amber. We're gonna find amber here. And then we're actually done with this shrine. Let's go ahead and mosey on up here. We can get another spirit orb here. Go ahead and talk to this guy. And as his containment shatters, I like the shattering, it's really cool. Man, it reminds me of Star Fox so much. Your resourcefulness is overcoming, and overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb. Get another Krazoa spirit. Get another Krazoa spirit. Man, I just love how this game looks. Another spirit orb. We have two now. May the goddess smile upon you. Now, if you go to the Temple of Time.
Oh,
excuse me. If you go to the Temple of Time, and you go to that statue where you go to, it's where you found the Traveler's Arrow for the first time. If you go there, you pray to the goddess, it will say, the goddess smiles upon you. It's kind of similar to what they say. Oh, we're going to go ahead and get rid of these guys right now. We're going to throw, and then ignite. Did I get hit by that? No way. I don't know how these things are still out. It's day. It's daylight. What the heck? Okay, so the guardian is up right now. It was crazy. So I was running away from this guardian, and it tracked me all the way up to the top of the mountain. I was like, how the heck did it do that? That's not her. It tracked me all the way up to this mountain. I'm like, how in the heck did the guardian track me all the way up here on this mountain? That was crazy. I thought I died. It like fired. It fired right behind me, which is crazy. Okay, so here is where. Oh man. Oh, that's not good. Okay, hopefully I pray that we can find some. Hopefully he has them in his little house here. But this is where the next shrine is. It's actually up there. If you guys can see it right there. We're not gonna go there yet. We're gonna save that for the next one. But today, we're just going to go around and take out these Bokoblin here. Probably find some new stuff. And tomorrow, I think I'm going to... Tomorrow? Probably not tomorrow. Probably the next day. The day before that. I'm going to record again. And we're going to continue on. Well, actually, yeah. So, by the time you guys watch this video, it's probably tomorrow. Because today's Saturday when I'm doing this. But, what are you doing, Link? Oh, that was close. So yeah, so probably it's gonna be tomorrow when you guys watch this. But I'm going to I'm getting sidetracked right now. We're gonna continue on to that shrine up there, and what are you doing, Link? Don't throw that. Man, what is wrong with you? I can't. The traveler's bow broke. Why? There we go. Let's get those bees away from me. But we're going to continue on. But we have a courser bee, or courser beehive. Honey straight from the hive is chock full of nutrients. Cooking this into a meal unlocks the potential of this these nutrients and providing the stamina recovery effect, which is true because I used it and my stamina was crazy. Where's a little shack? So we're gonna go here real quick, but before that, we're gonna grab these. And what's that? What's that up there? What is that? What mushroom are these? Rushrooms, a mushroom that can grow almost anywhere, but prefers ceilings and sheer cliffs. Cooking it before eating it will temporarily increase speed or movement speed. Okay. Like I said, there's more to it than cooking than just doing it. To recover health or something, you can use it as many other things. Look at that. And so we're gonna go over to this man's house. Since it's during the day, he should be up. Yeah, so he's gonna be over here. You're gonna find him chopping trees, and he's gonna kind of show us how to chop trees with our axe if we haven't done it already. Fancy that. So we meet again. What are you doing? I thought these trees here might make some good firewood. However, getting all trees falling exactly where you want it is quite an art. I got tongue tied. I don't know. The trick is to turn your hips so they face where you want the tree to land. So I see you found my axe. Why not help me out and give it a few swings? I'm working up a sweat here, but these bones could give a break. All right, so this is going to show.
Oh,
wow. Oh, my gosh. Why? So we're going to go ahead and cut down this tree. It's really nothing to it to cut down trees in here. It really isn't. And also, you can make bridges from them, so we're going to go ahead and face this way, and then one more whack at it. Boom. The tree is falling. And then you get tree branches, too, which is pretty cool. Okay, cool. I have not fall, and I have yet to fall. Oh, we don't have a bow. That's not good. That's a shield. What are you doing? I didn't even mean to do that, and I didn't know you could whistle. I mean, I know you could whistle, but I didn't think, like, it would... There we go, crit him. Of course, he's still up. I didn't know, like... That's crazy. I want to do a fury before I'm done. Oh, wow, okay. Oh, no, 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 no! 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 He knocked me off. He knocked me off. What? I was not expecting that. That was crazy. Okay, no, we're not showing off. We're just going to finish this guy off. I'm going to do a fury swipe, and he knocked me off. Oh my gosh, the whole entire thing. That's crazy. Whoa. I never noticed that. Can we blow that up? Can we? Yes, we can. Look at this. This is my third playthrough, and I did not notice this here. Fire arrows. Okay, cool. Nice. Alright, so we cut down the tree. We took out those guys. One guy took me out. Oh my gosh. I did not expect to be knocked off the cliff like that. That's crazy. We're just cut down this tree, and then let's go ahead and end it. Grab all these apples. These apples will be very helpful. while making recipes. Okay. Let's. Oh, no. Let's actually go down there and then we're gonna end the episode off. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. And my sword's about to break, but it's all good. How do you jump? Okay. I was like, how do you jump? We should have a bulk of another shield. There we go. We should have another bulk of a shield. So we are gonna actually end it. Well, let's do this too. I did this, and this is actually pretty cool. You can hit those birds, and then you get. Did I get it? Raw bird drumstick. So we got that, and we're gonna go ahead and take these guys out real quick. Let's go ahead and crit this dude, can we? Look at that! Oh, that skill. My arrow skills are awesome right now. Is that explosives? No, it's not. Well, we have fire arrows, so let's go ahead and kind of get rid of these guys pretty quickly. We're like, what happened? What's going on? Oh, this dude's on fire. I thought. That. Oh, he moved. He sees me. Did that rock reach up there? There we go. He's done. Let's not waste arrows right now. Let's not waste arrows. Let's just go down there and finish these dudes off. What am I doing? Oh, what? Okay, that kind of freaked me out. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, so dramatic. We fin we broke my sword and finished him off. That was awesome. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and grab this. Go up here. What's I forgot what's in here. What's in here? Okay, that's what I'm talking about. The throwing spear, which is pretty cool. A specialized spear weighted to excel as a throwing spear. It's perfectly balanced to be thrown further than your average spear. I'm able to pierce targets from a great distance. My problem is, oh, we're gonna make room for it, don't worry. My problem is with that is if we use it, is it gonna disappear? Like that's my problem with it. Like if I actually throw it, is it will I be able to get it? Will it break? I'm pretty sure it won't because it's a throwing spear and that's the purpose of it. But it would suck if it broke after I like threw it and I never got it back. My arrow's back here. And we're going to use our bombs. Toss and then boom. I don't know why I didn't like blow up the beehive here. Let's go ahead and use it. Throw. Boom. Okay, cool. So take out the bees, which is nice. What's this? I forgot what it was. Bomb arrows. Okay, we have bomb arrows there. Get that. Then we have some stamina mushrooms, which brings up our stamina. And there's a mushroom here. And that's it. We're gonna call it actually. And then we're gonna make our way up to that mountain over there. Let's grab this actually. Right. And we're gonna call it actually. So hope you guys enjoy this video, because I absolutely enjoy playing this game. This game is so much fun. If you guys did, go ahead and hit the like button on there. It lets me know you guys are enjoying the video. Also, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe because there's going to be more Zelda stuff. I'm gonna actually complete this game 100%. I'll try to do 100%. I'm not gonna guarantee 100%. I'm gonna try to do 100% on this video, on this game. So, yeah. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the video, and you guys have